This video is called Solve Trinomials by Factoring 2. So we know that we have to factor it and then set everything equal to 0 so I can see where this polynomial, which is a parabola, see where it crosses the x-axis on a graph. Before I start factoring though, I recognize I can take out a GCF. I can pull out a 2. So I have an x squared plus 3x minus 4 left. So now that I'm ready to factor, I've just made it a lot easier and simpler on myself to see what multiplies to give me negative 4 and adds to give me positive 3. Well, 4 is a 4 and 1 or a 2 and 2. I think a positive 4 and a negative 1 can add to give me a positive 3, and a positive 4 times a negative 1 can multiply to give me negative 4. So, I continue on with my two parentheses. Don't forget to bring down the 2 and the equal 0. I'll split up my x. I'll put the plus 4 in one parenthesis, the minus 1 in the other. And now I remember I've got three terms to set equal to 0. 2 equals 0, x plus 4 equals 0, x minus 1 equals 0. Well, 2 will never equal 0, so I can get rid of that choice or that option. Here, when I subtract 4 from both sides, I get x equals negative 4. And when I add 1, I get x equals 1. So those are my answers. But just to make sure you understand what's going on, remember, if you were going to put these on a graph, at 1 and negative 4 is where this parabola would cross the x-axis. So we'd have a sketch like that. The second problem for this video, again, we want to solve trinomials by factoring, but I notice this is not in the right form yet to solve. I need to get all my terms on the left-hand side of the equal sign, so I'm going to add 24 to both sides. So I get x squared minus 25x plus 24 equals 0. Can I take out a GCF? No, because I don't have an x in all three terms, and I don't have a number bigger than 1 in all three terms that I can factor out. So we'll start by thinking about what multiplies to give us a positive 24 and adds to give us a negative 25. Well, factors of 24 are 24 and 1, 12 and 2, 8 and 3, 6 and 4. Which set will multiply to give me a positive 24 and add to give me a negative 25? Well, a negative 24 plus a negative 1. So I make my two parentheses. I don't forget to bring down my equal 0. I've got x minus 24 and x minus 1. So it looks like I have two different terms. I've got to split it up and set them equal to 0. So I'm going to add 24. So I have x equals 24, and I'm going to add 1, so I have x equals 1. So if I were going to graph this, I would know that my parabola, my U shape, would cross the x-axis way out at 24 and at 1.